developments on foreign policy front. I will give an overview of some of these developments, engagements briefly. Details have already been conveyed to you all. The Indian occupation forces during so-called cordon and search operations martyred 40 Kashmiris, including Zakir Rashid, Faisal Nazir Mir, Umar Ahmed, Asif Ahmed, Nasir Ahmed Mir, Yavar Ahmed Najar, Junaid Ayub Bage, Abid Manjoor Magre, Hilal Ahmed Bhatt, Zahur Ahmed Sheikh, Amjad Mahmood Maknu, Sajjad Ahmed, Jaseem Rashid Shah, Mehran Ahmed Bande, Firdaus Ahmed Bhatt, Sajjad Ahmed Dar, Ashik Ahmed Ghania, Imran Ahmed, Shabir Ahmed Dar, Salman Ahmed Khan, Muhammad Iqbal Ghani, Sayyar Ahmed Bhatt, Shakir Ahmed, Nasir Ahmed Mir, Sadiq Amin Shah, Irfan Ahmed, Sajjad Maqbool Bhatt, Tawseef Ahmed, Shaukat Ahmed, Azad Ahmed Khande, Suhail Yusuf Bhatt, Rafiq Hassan Mir, Shabir Ahmed Malik, Adil Rahman and Hilal Ahmed Bhatt. In Pulwama, Shupian, Bandipur, Baramula, Badgam and Srinagar districts of the Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir. We remain gravely concerned over continued illegal detention despite deteriorating health of senior Hurriyat leaders including Muhammad Yasin Malik, Shabir Ahmed Shah, Masarat Alam Bhatt, Dr. Hamid Fayaz, Sayyida Asiya Andrabi, Nahida Nasreen, Fahmida Sofi, Naeem Ahmed Khan, Muhammad Ayar Akbar, Altaf Ahmed Shah, Peer Saifullah, Mirajuddin Kalwal, Farooq Ahmed Dar, Maulana Sarjan Barkati, Qazi Yasir Ahmed, Sayyid Shahid Yusuf, Sayyid Shakil Ahmed, Zahur Ahmed Batali, Shahidul Islam, Advocate Zahid Ali, Maulana Mushtaq Miri, Muhammad Yusuf Mir, and over 1,000 other Hurriyat leaders, activists, and students languishing in the notorious Indian Tihar Jail in New Delhi and various other jails. We also condemn the undemocratic act of Indian authorities who denied permission for an event of Amnesty International India chapter to release its report on Black Law, Public Safety Act, titled Tyranny of a Lawless Law, Detention Without Charge or Trial under the Jammu and Kashmir Public Safety Act in Srinagar on June 12, 2019. We strongly condemn the arrest of an editor of a Srinagar-based newspaper, Afaq Ghulam Jilani, by the Indian administration in a 27-year-old case, which is yet another attempt to muzzle freedom of press in IOK. India should stop misleading the international community and accept the ground realities and aspirations of the people of IOK instead of continuing with its policy of obduracy in the territory. You must have seen the report in which the International Commission of Jurists has joined other NGOs in drawing the attention of the UN Human Rights Council to extrajudicial killings and enforced disappearances in the Indian-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. The statement delivered by International Federation for Human Rights Leagues, FIDH, on behalf of Asian Forum for Human Rights and Development, Forum Asia, Human Rights Watch, International Commission of Jurists and World Organization Against Torture, OMCT, reads as follows, and I quote, "We look forward to the publication of High Commissioner for Human Rights' second ever report on the grave human rights violations and abuses committed in Jammu and Kashmir. In Indian-administered Kashmir, government forces have been responsible for serious violations including unlawful killings, enforced disappearances, torture and rape, and other sexual violence. These grave violations of security forces in Kashmir are met with chronic impunity, as alleged perpetrators are rarely properly prosecuted for human rights violations, leading to near total immunity for the crimes committed. Non-state armed groups have also been responsible for serious abuses, including attacks against journalists. We are gravely concerned by the increasing threats faced by and reprisals against human rights defenders and others who have cooperated with UN human rights mechanisms in the recent years, particularly in the elaboration of the OHCHR's report. We urge the Government of India to ensure that human rights defenders and journalists are allowed to carry out their work without threats or reprisals and take adequate steps to protect them from non-state groups. Moving forward, on 2nd July, Pakistan conveyed to India that the second meeting to discuss the draft agreement for finalizing the modalities of Kartarpur Sahib corridor and related technical issues will be held on 14th July at Wagah. The Indian side has been requested to convey the composition of its delegation. Pakistan remains committed to expedited progress on the matter to ensure that the corridor is operationalized in time for the 550th birth anniversary celebrations of Baba Guru Nanak Sahib in November 2019. The US administration has designated the Balochistan Liberation Army BLA as specially designated global terrorist SDGT. BLA remains a proscribed entity in Pakistan since 2006 and in recent times has carried out several terrorist attacks in the country. It is important that the perpetrators, organizers, financiers and external sponsors, including those glorifying these acts of terror against Pakistan, are held accountable and brought to justice. On the invitation of Prime Minister Imran Khan, President of Afghanistan Ashraf Ghani visited Pakistan on 27-28 June. President Ghani was accompanied by a high-level delegation including ministers, advisors, senior officials and businessmen. A detailed press release was issued. Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi had wide-ranging and productive engagements during his two-day visit to Brussels, Belgium, 24-25 of June. The foreign minister visited NATO headquarters and met with its secretary-general. He also addressed the EU's Political and Security Committee. But most importantly, he signed the EU-Pakistan Strategic Engagement Plan during his visit. Also, His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, Emir of State of Qatar, undertook a two-day visit to Pakistan, 22-23 June. He was accompanied by a high-power delegation comprising key ministers and senior officials. The visit was marked by exceptional warmth and cordiality. All aspects of bilateral relations came under review. Leadership of both the brotherly Islamic countries reaffirmed the closeness of Pakistan-Qatar fraternal ties and reiterated the resolve to forge a robust political and economic partnership. And I thank you all and I will take your questions. جناب اور سوال فالو اپ بس جی ایٹ دی انویٹیشن آف یو ایس پریزیڈنٹ ڈونلڈ ٹرمپ پرائم منسٹر عمران خان ول وزٹ واشنگٹن ڈی سی اینڈ ہولڈ اے میٹنگ وتھ پریزیڈنٹ ٹرمپ آن 22nd جولائی 2019 دی ایجنڈا آف دا میٹنگ از بینگ ڈیولپڈ تھرو ڈپلومیٹک چینلز اے ڈیٹیلڈ کرٹن ریزر ول بی ایشوڈ بفور دا وزٹ جلدی ہم کر دیں گے The focus will be to refresh the bilateral relationship. Rashta. جناب خالد خان
جو حالت کی جانتے ہیں خراب ہے
I refer you to the press, Janab. I will refer you to our press release. Pakistan has confirmed 14 July to India for the meeting. Work continues on Kartarpur Sahib corridor on our side. We hope for expedited progress in the meeting to ensure operationalization of the corridor for the 550th birth anniversary celebrations of Baba Guru Nanak Sahib. I have no information of invitation to Prime Minister Modi ji. We are going there in a very positive spirit. Some decisions in this context would be taken soon, and I will update you accordingly. Abhi ek hafta takriban, ek hafte se zyada pada hai, is pe actively kaam ho raha hai. Choice saab ji.
अब वजीर आजम के दौरे अमेरिका से कबल अमेरिका ने उनको टेररिस्ट डेजिग्नेट किया है. आप क्या समझते हैं ये अमेरिका की जानिब से पाकिस्तान की जो उसकी कोशिश है उनका जवाब है या दोनों ममालिक के दरमियान जिस तरह आपने कहा कि तालुबात को रिफ्रेश करने के हवाले से इकदाम किए जा रहे हैं तो अमरीका ने वो जैसा शो किया.
प्लीज नवी साहब से ले लें फिर आपके पास आ जाते हैं.
सर आपकी जो प्रेस रिलीज
बात हो रही है जो एक बैन लगाया गया इंटरनेशनल सर इस हवाले से दीगर ममालिकानिया के अंदर इसकी एक्टिविटीज जो है वो बड़ी पुरजोश अंदाज में वर्ल्ड कप के दौरान भी आपने मुलाजा फरमाई होगी और वहाँ पे बाकायदा तौर पे पाकिस्तान के हवाले से भारतीय जो प्रोपेगेंडा वो अरविंद के ऊपर है तो क्या बरतानवी जो हुकाम ने उनसे इस हवाले से बातचीत की जैसे अमेरिका ने इस तरह की एक स्टांस रख लिया तो दीगर यूरोपीय ममालिक के अंदर चूंकि देखा जा रहा है
जी इसको हमने एक्टिवली उठाया. अगर आपने देखा हो अभी फॉरेन मिनिस्टर पे कॉल ऑन कर रहे थे ब्रिटिश हाई कमिश्नर उसमें भी ये उठाया. जो प्रेस रिलीज है वो सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी है उसकी तफसील में मैं नहीं जाना चाहूँगा. हमने अपनी पोजीशन दे दी. सॉरी उन्होंने रियलाइज किया है जी जो हम बात उठा रहे थे उसको एक्नॉलेज किया है और रियलाइज किया है और इनको दहशतगर्द डिक्लेयर किया है. हम इस सिलसिले में अपनी काविशें जारी रखें.
सर 22 मई को सर ईरान के वजीर खारजा पाकिस्तान तशरीफ लाए थे एंड इज मीटिंग विद फॉरेन मिनिस्टर शाह महमूद कुरैशी ही पुट अ प्रपोजल फॉरवर्ड टू कनेक्ट पाकिस्तान्स गवर्नर पोर्ट टू शाहबहार तो इस हवाले से पाकिस्तान ने कोई जवाब दिया है ईरान को इस हवाले से आई पाकिस्तान ने डिसाइसिव मोड और नॉट.
मैं चेक करके आपको बता सकता हूं. और
शुक्रिया सर प्राइम मिनिस्टर इमरान खान की स्पेशल असिस्टेंट है नई मुल्क पाकिस्तान रिपोर्टेडली रेडी पाकिस्तान स्पोर्टिंग तालिबान लीडर्स विल सून कम टू पाकिस्तान टू मीट प्राइम मिनिस्टर इमरान खान. कुछ कमेंट ऑन दिस वेदर दिस विजिट इज लिंक्ड विद द ऑनगोइंग पीस प्रोसेस इन दोहा and the inter-Afghan meeting which is going to take place on 7th and 8th July. Would you like to comment and whether this Taliban leader's visit is connected to these weapons, please? Thank you.
I can't comment on the visit, Ji. But I can say that Pakistan has played a pivotal role in facilitating and taking forward the peace process. We are doing this in good faith and as a shared responsibility. The ultimate decision regarding political settlement is in the hands of the Afghan people. Pakistan would continue stressing the need for an Afghan-led and Afghan-owned peace process. We hope that these talks could ultimately lead to the result-oriented intra-Afghan dialogue. Namit sir. जी
सर, ये बता दीजिए कि प्रेसिडेंट अशरफ और सरहद पार से दहशतगर्द यहाँ पर कार्रवाइयाँ करते हुए एविडेंस भी फ्रेश उनके साथ शेयर
forward the peace process, which is widely appreciated. Regarding this question, ji, President Ashraf Ghani ke visit se mutallika, Pakistan and Afghanistan attach high priority to enhance bilateral trade and economic relations. During recent visit of Afghan President to Pakistan, both sides reaffirmed their commitment to adopt a forward-looking approach and to strengthen ties in all areas of mutual interest, including political, trade, economic and investment, cultural and educational spheres. They also discussed to effectively utilize the existing economic mechanism, such as holding of meetings of the Joint Economic Commission and Pakistan-Afghanistan Transit Trade Coordination Authority, and to address all outstanding issues concerning trade and Afghan transit trade at the earliest. The leadership identified trade, economic cooperation and regional connectivity as two important points of convergence for future partnership. In order to promote bilateral trade, steps such as opening of Torkham border for 24 hours and enhancing transit trade access and connectivity to neighborhood for both countries were also discussed. Further discussions in this regard would continue in the coming weeks and months. Ji Paracha sahab. Cover over.
Thank you, sir. In your absence, there were reports, multiple reports, that Modi, Prime Minister of India, will be visiting Pakistan and he will have a...
Raya sahab, sawal bahut premature hai. 14 ki meeting to kar lein. Raya sahab, aap pehle khatoon, peeche. Aa rahe hain.
Thank you. Indian Parliament gave its approval for extending President's rule in the Jammu and Kashmir, for 6 months. From 3rd July onward. And the Union Minister Amit Shah said that the centre is committed for bringing Kashmiri Sufis and Pandits back to the valley. So your comments, please.
We have repeatedly said that any solution of the Jammu and Kashmir dispute has to take into account the will of the Kashmiri people. And it has to be as per the UN Security Council resolutions. India is shirking from that. They have remained unsuccessful. They are trying to crush the struggle in Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir. They are failing abysmally. I can reiterate that India should come back to the dialogue table and find a political solution as per the UN Security Council resolutions to the Jammu and Kashmir dispute and as per the wishes of the Kashmiri people. Anas ji, pehla sawal to kar le janab log.
Sir, thank you so much. Very briefly, I have four questions.
Four?
Yes, because it's coming after a while.
Two. You can have two.
Let's say four. Sir, there's a case that is ongoing in British court on with regards to the extradition of Javed Motiwala, a Pakistani businessman. And in the same case, reportedly the FBI has pleaded that it has evidence with regard to Dawood Ibrahim's presence in Pakistan. What is Pakistan's take on that? Number one. Yesterday we saw Hafiz Saeed's terror.
One ka jawab le lenge. Daud Ibrahim is not, and I repeat, not in Pakistan. And ye case ki ko detail hai, toh I'll check from the mission. I don't know.
Yesterday, Hafiz Saeed was put on in a case on terror financing. What is Pakistan's take on the matter?
Interior Ministry, ji. Subject is Interior Ministry.
Thirdly, on the 10th of July, too, the Pakistani Foreign Minister and the Indian Foreign Minister will be under the same roof of the ambit of Commonwealth Foreign Ministers. Are we expecting a meeting? And number four,
no.
No meeting?
No.
Lastly, there were reports that 8 embassies have been, their containers have been reportedly stopped on charges that they were smuggling glitter into Pakistan under the ambit of food items. Your comment on that? Thank you.
No meeting is envisaged. Ye likhkar check kar le protocol se ji, we'll get back to you on because this is directly, to I don't have any. Faisal sahab ji piche fir aapke paas aate hain.
Sir, just yesterday Pakistan and Tajikistan has a 6th joint commission meeting in Dushanbe. During that meeting, whether the alternative routes, Central Asian Republics, would also be discussed, because earlier Pakistan has a proposal because of the Afghan territory's ongoing war-like situation. Pakistan has proposed a route through Sinkiang to Tajikistan and Central Asian Republics. Whether that alternative route would be was discussed in that meeting, and what would be the modalities for that, particularly to enhance trade to Central Asian Republics through CPEC and the rest of the routes which are available through Pakistan and through Central Asia.
Thank you, Faisal Saab. The question is very good. Thoda sa premature hai. Is pe bahut sa kaam ho raha. Hum aapko itla is pe karenge. Jana. Jaavid Bukhari,
sir. Pushna ye tha ki ek to kal blast hua hai LOC ke nazdeek. Kya hum uska intezaam kar diye hai foreign office ke usse? Number two, kya uski koi aur detail aayi hai? Kyunki kal jo detail thi wo bhi premature thi aur ISBI se bataya gaya ki uski wahi pe andaaza lagaya ja raha hai.
जी इशू को उठा लिया गया था उसी वक्त और उस पर जाहिर डिप्लोमेटिक प्रोसेस हैं वो चल रहे हैं. पहला सवाल है LOC पे तफसील आ रही है जी, अभी तक मेरे पास एग्जैक्ट तफसील नहीं आई है. इट सीम्स के उसमें कोई इंडियन साइड से इन्वॉल्वमेंट थी. जैसे ही कन्फर्मेशन हो जाए तो जो प्रोसेस हैं वो इन प्ले आ जाएंगे. अभी तक मेरे पास फाइनल इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं आई, मगर 5 शहादतें हुई हैं. वी आर प्राउड ऑफ आवर सोल्जर्स. एक ज़ख्मी है और जो जाने दे रहे हैं इस चीज़ के लिए, और ये कंडेमेबल एक्ट है. ये तो फैक्ट है कि ये वाक़यात हुए हैं और LOC के बिल्कुल साथ कहीं ये वाक़या हुआ है. थोड़ी सी तफसील आ जाए तो फिर आपके साथ शेयर भी कर लेंगे. दो पीछे जी से. Thank you, Sib. I'll check on the Saudi prisoners thing, and we can't comment on our position on Israel is well known, very clear, but we can't comment on Gulf relations to Israel. I think that's about it. Thank you very much.